Okay, we're going to do one here. This is called ethene. It's C2H4. And we want to write the dot structures for ethene. So to do that, we always count our valence electrons up first. Let's take a look at the carbon is in group 4, sometimes written 14. So it has 4 valence electrons. If we come way over here to hydrogen, it's in group 1. It has 1 valence electron. So 4 for the carbon, but there's 2 of them, so we multiply it times 2, plus 1 for the hydrogen, but there's 4 of those, so we multiply that times 4. So 2 times 4 is 8, plus 4, 8 plus 4 is 12. So we have a total of 12 valence electrons to work with here. We're going to have to spread them around. So let's just write out, we always put carbons, we always put the hydrogens, see, let's move down some here, on the outside. So let's put our 4 hydrogens on the outside. And let's ignore this right here. And let's put 2 electrons between each bond. So they're chemically bonded, lower energy, more stable, and then 1 in the middle. So I've used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I've got 12 more, so I'll put those out here. But my problem is that now I've got 2, 4, 6, 8 for that one, but this carbon only has 6. So I can't, with those 12 electrons, satisfy the octet. So what I'm going to do is take these and stick them right here in what's called a double bond. Now, if I cover up this side, I've got 2, 4, 6, 8. If I cover up this side, I've got 2, 4, 6, 8. And I've only used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So I used my 12 electrons to form a double bond here that gives carbon an octet, and then hydrogen, they each have 2, so their outer shells are full. Sometimes you'll see that written like this, the double bond showing you the 2 pairs. And I suppose you could write your H's. Often they'll show the single bond like that with the H's. So that's kind of abbreviated format for the dots. So there you have it, ethene.